Do y'all remember in 1999 when everybody was prophesying that God was going to get in the computer system because the world systems were not made to go past 2,000 years? Do y'all remember that? Because no dispensation ever made it past 2,000 years. Let me tell you where we are right now in the realm of the spirit. Satan thought we would have been wiped out. That we've been praying for. God said it snuck up on you. It crept up on you unawares.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
So you got to shift. Say your name, a shift real quick. Get on out that place that you in. You better shift real quick. Said that better is the end of a thing than the beginning. The scripture said that at the, some say, this is what people say, but this is not what the Bible said. Let me help y'all. So we're going to get a little Bible study tonight. He said, some, this is what some people say. The seventh year is the year of release. Think about that. And I want you to allow your mind to go all the way back to like 2003 to 2004. Think about all of the hell and the chaos and the noise that you were in right then. Think about that. Think about that if you can think that far. And they say, this is what people say, and the seventh year is the year of release. Now, the word of God said, the seventh year is the year of release. And I come to tell 10 people at night that will grab this by faith. You at the end of your seventh year. When the thing you've been praying for is being released. Not only are things being released, but stuff that you lost, God is giving back double. That's what the Bible said. At the end of the seventh year is the year of release. That means you don't owe nothing. And everything that you lost, the people that took it, are required to give you back. The devil fought y'all so hard to even get to this place. He fought you tooth and nail to get you to this place. But guess what? It's too late. Because now that I'm here, there ain't nothing he can do about it. Let that soak right there, because faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of the Lord. Let that soak. Let that word soak in you. Let that word soak for a moment. Let that word soak for a moment. Let that thing soak for a moment, because some of you won't even allow your mind and your spirit to believe God for something that's intangible, because you've had so many disappointments that have messed with your faith. But God said, I'm going to do it whether you believe it or not. I'm getting you ready for your harvest. I'm trying to get you ready for your harvest. I'm trying to get you ready for your harvest. Y'all don't even understand that, because so much prayer and anointing and power is in this building the moment you put your foot on this parking lot today. Because we're here. Look at soul. Let that soul. Because I'm letting that devil know that I'm no longer intimidated by him.
Yeah.
I'm letting that devil know that I don't have to see it in your back account to believe it. I'm letting that devil know, as a matter of fact, he can keep his money. I got favor with God. I'm working tonight. I feel like I'm at a one-night revival. Because God done turned it around. God done turned it around. God done turned it around. I'm not up here ministering just because I don't want to get to the word, because I got a word. I got notes and all of this up here that I need to be teaching, that I've been trying to get to for the past couple of weeks. But y'all don't even know that this church, this ministry, Gentile, is under a visitation.
Yeah.
And you cannot take it lightly.
Yeah.
If you can, see, I'm trying, but I'm way out there today. I'm way out there. Because I got to just let the devil know that everything that he tried didn't work.